Hello and welcome back to Hazmat Shipping Essentials, the video series all about how to offer hazardous materials for transportation safely and legally in the United States. I'm Roger with Lion Technology. Already in this series, we've explored the entire universe of hazards regulated in transportation. In our All 9 Hazard Classes Explained video, we covered each of the classes and divisions and the types of materials assigned to each one. So we know, for example, that explosives belong in Class 1, dangerous gases belong in Class 2, flammable liquids belong in Hazard Class 3, and so on, and that is a great start. But we need to know more than that if we want to properly classify a hazardous material. Here's an example of what I mean. Some household drain cleaners are regulated as Class 8 corrosive materials in transportation. You may know that. And so is pure sulfuric acid. Now, drain cleaner and sulfuric acid are both corrosive according to DOT's criteria, but do they really belong in the same category, danger-wise? In this video, you're going to see how the hazardous materials regulations rank materials within each hazard class or division based on the severity of the hazard. So get ready, because this is where we separate the big-time hazardous materials from the, well, the stuff like drain cleaner. For most hazardous materials, in most hazard classes and divisions, severity of hazard is handled by dividing the class or division into three packing groups, 1, 2, and 3, with packing group 1, or PG1, representing the most severe hazard, and packing group 3, or PG3, representing the least severe hazard. In our sulfuric acid versus drain cleaner example, sulfuric acid is our Class A packing group 1 material, the most severe hazard. Drain cleaner, when it's regulated as hazmat, generally falls into the least severe hazard category, packing group 3. Assigning your material to the correct packing group is essential to comply with U.S. and international hazmat and dangerous goods regulations. Packing group affects how you name your material, the type of packaging required, the quantity limits you follow, your shipping papers, your cargo security planning responsibilities, even what modes of transportation you can use. In this video, we're going to focus on the hazard classes and divisions that use packing groups to designate degrees of hazard. We're going to follow this up with a second video about the classes and divisions that categorize hazards differently, how they do it, and why they do it that way. To talk packing groups, we start with hazard class 3. Class 3 flammable liquids are categorized into packing group 1, 2, or 3 based on the material's boiling point and/or flash point. As a reminder, flash point is the temperature at which a liquid will give off enough vapor to form an ignitable mixture with the air. Now, except for self-reactive materials, which we're going to cover in the next video, division 4.1 flammable solids are assigned to a packing group based on the results of testing according to the UN Manual of Tests and Criteria. The tests for these types of materials measure more or less how long something burns and the rate it burns at. For division 4.2, spontaneously combustible materials, pyrophoric liquids and solids are assigned to packing group 1. You may remember from our All 9 Hazard Classes video, pyrophoric means the material will catch fire when exposed to the air. Self-heating materials, meanwhile, are assigned to packing group 2 or 3 based on test results. On to division 4.3, dangerous when wet materials, for which the packing group 1, 2, and 3 designations are determined by how vigorously or readily the material reacts with water, the likelihood of flammable or ignitable gas forming, and the rate at which those gases form. Division 5.1 oxidizers that are solids are assigned to packing group 1, 2, or 3 based again here on the results of tests outlined in the UN Manual of Tests and Criteria. The UN tests for division 5.1s measure the mean burning time for a material. For liquid 5.1 materials, packing group is assigned differently based on the rate of pressure change in the material or whether it will spontaneously ignite under certain conditions. For division 6.1 poisons, PG 1, 2, and 3 assignments are based on oral toxicity and dermal toxicity expressed as a median lethal dose, or LD50, and inhalation toxicity expressed as lethal concentration, or LC50. There are alternate packing groups 1, 2, and 3 for division 6.1 liquids that give off vapors that are poisonous when inhaled. For these materials, packing group 1 is split into two hazard zones, A and B. A good thing about having four categories instead of three is that it provides a very clear-cut upper range that distinguishes the most severe inhalation hazards. With these materials that are poisoned by inhalation, the less uncertainty, the better. Corrosive materials in Class 8 are assigned packing group 1, 2, or 3 based on the rate at which they can cause irreversible damage to skin and/or steel or aluminum. And Class 9, this is our miscellaneous hazard class. When it comes to packing group, some Class 9s are assigned a packing group, others are not. If your material is a Class 9 and it has a packing group, that will be listed in the HAZMAT table in 49 CFR Part 172.101 in Column 5. We have to look to the table for Class 9s because there is no set criteria for dividing these up. Again, it's the miscellaneous hazard class, so these materials don't necessarily have that much in common, besides that they all pose some hazard in transportation. Ask yourself, which of these presents a more severe potential hazard? A lithium battery or a can of bear repellent spray? Well, it depends if you're a bear. I'm joking, but you get the idea. If you want to see just how miscellaneous Class 9 can get, check out our All About Hazard Class 9 video, where we go long on the types of hazmat that end up in Class 9, from asbestos and pepper spray to some hazardous waste, CERCLA hazardous substances, hot materials, and more. Well, those are your packing groups. It is important to say that a hazardous material and its packing group are not always a one-to-one match. Think back to our corrosive drain cleaner one more time. Now, you won't find drain cleaner listed on the HAZMAT table. A common generic shipping name used is corrosive liquid, not otherwise specified, or NOS. For tips on using generic shipping names and NOS names, including rules for modifying them, see the video description now. Here's some details for our drain cleaner that I cribbed from the DOT HAZMAT table. We can see that it is listed as a Class 8 Packing Group 3 material, or at least it can be, but Packing Group 1 and Packing Group 2 are listed here as well with the same shipping name. To know for sure which packing group our generic corrosive liquid belongs to, we need to refer to the criteria in 49 CFR Part 173. Remember, for corrosives, that's going to mean how fast the material can destroy skin or certain metals. With that, I'm going to pack it in on our discussion of HAZMAT packing groups, at least for now. If you're new to HAZMAT compliance and could use some insights to help simplify your responsibilities, Lion's step-by-step HAZMAT shipper starter guide is still available for free at lion.com/start. That guide lays out essentials about HAZMAT classification, shipping names, packaging, shipping papers, incident reporting, and more. It's a valuable resource, especially for beginners. It's free, and there's a link in the video description to grab it now. If you need training for yourself or your employees to keep HAZMAT shipments moving safely, uninterrupted, and in compliance with U.S. and international regulations, visit lion.com/hazmat today to browse upcoming workshops, live webinars, and self-paced online courses for professionals at any level of experience or responsibility. Thank you for hanging in with me through this video on HAZMAT packing groups. Remember, there is a second video coming behind this one that's going to cover all the classes and divisions we didn't touch on here. We'll be talking explosives, toxic gases, radioactive materials, and more, so subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell now because you won't want to miss what's coming up next. Thanks again. I'll see you in the next video.